Hey y'all, welcome to another episode of Tech Tuesday brought to you by Victory Archery. My name is Nate Watts. I'm the QC manager here at the company. So as you can see, I got some stuff sitting in front of me here today. If you don't know what this stuff is, I'm going to tell you. So we're going to be talking about spine today. And what this is right here, this is a RAM spine tester. Now it's a pretty expensive tool, but it's a very useful tool. What it's going to tell you is the exact spine of your arrow. And it's going to tell you what the stiffest part of the arrow is versus the weakest. But I wanted to build something that allows you to find that a lot faster. And I'm going to show you guys how that works right now. So with regards to spine, the first question everybody always has is, how do I fletch my arrow? Do I line up the cock vein with the spine marking? And the simple answer is yes. But here's the deal. As long as all of your arrows are fletched identical to each other, meaning if I fletched all my arrows with the cock vein 90 degrees from the spine marking, as long as they're all fletched the same way, they're gonna be consistent with each other. Now, if I've got one cock vein on spine, one at 3 o'clock, one at 6 o'clock, one at 9 o'clock, they're not gonna shoot consistent with each other. The reason for that being is our spine marking is marked on the stiff axis of arrow, not the high spine, but the stiff axis, meaning that's going to be the stiffest axis of the arrow. So this would be the weakest, this would be the stiffest. Now, we found through lots of testing, slow motion video, that the proper alignment is vertical out of a compound bow with a release. So you want the stiff axis on the vertical plane, just because the way the cam cycle works and how it propels that arrow shaft, you want that to be vertical on your paradox. Now, out of a traditional bow, Olympic recurve, you want that paradox to be horizontal. So you want your cock vein on the horizontal plane. So when the stiff axis is on the horizontal plane, I'm sorry. So when you release, that arrow is gonna flex horizontally around that riser. And that's just the nature of how you release on the string versus a trigger or back tension release out of the compound. So, but as long as all of your arrows are fletched identical to each other, they're going to be consistent with each other. So what this tool does is I can put an arrow on here. So I'm gonna lift this up, put my arrow shaft on here. Kind of hard to do backward. Make sure this is turned on. And then I'm going to zero it. And then I've got a weight that I can hang off of the shaft here. And however far this drops is going to tell me the exact spine. Now, when you order this, it's going to have an analog gauge on there. I've upgraded mine to a digital gauge just to give me a little bit, you know, more consistent reading, a little more sensitive. And then you would just rotate this to find your high spine, weak spine, or stiff axis defects. So, which is great. Takes a little bit of time, some patience, and if you got the time and patience to sit there, awesome. If you don't, another tool that you can put together very, very easily is this. So basically what I did is just three brackets and three sets of bearings. Now, you want to use a rounded bearing on here just so you don't damage the carbon. Putting a sharp point into carbon and rotating it can damage the carbon. Don't recommend it, but cool thing about this is what I can do is I can flex this arrow shaft. I know that these are going to flex. So I want to flex this and I'm going to put it in here. And what's going to happen is I'm going to rotate this and it's going to snap to the weak spine. So it's because it's under tension, when I rotate this, it's going to snap to the weakest part of the spine. So when this one pushes this way, right here on the bottom is going to be the weakest part of your spine. So I can rotate this and you can see it snaps right there. So if I look down, I can see that my spine marking is 90 degrees from where this is pushing. So I know that my spine marking is on the stiff axis of arrow. So I was actually going through some of these RIP SS today, just double checking some stuff and wanted to verify. And it gets a little bit tougher to turn, and then it'll just snap. And it just rolls real quick right to the weak axis of the arrow. Not the weakest part of the spine, but the weak axis. So I know that my stiff axis is exactly 90 degrees from my weak axis. And knowing the axis allows me to make sure that I put my veins at the same spot on the stiff axis of the arrow along with the spine marking. And as long as all my arrows are fletched the same, they're gonna react the same way out of the bow and be very consistent with each other. So, like I said, you can order this tool, it's great if you've got the time, but if you're like me and trying to get a bunch of stuff built, always busy, always have something going on, and you just wanna verify, or you know, a lot of times I'm testing arrows that don't have any markings on them yet, doing prototype testing, you know, new product development, stuff like that, and I need to verify very quickly what the stiff axis is so I can get some fletched up, so I can do breakage tests, durability testing, all that. I'll use this, and like I said, very easy to make. Some sets of bearings, some brackets, piece of acrylic, and as long as you're not flexing too much and damaging the shaft, you're gonna have to flex it enough. Flexing too little won't work, but it definitely helps, and I hope that kind of explains the reason that we have a spine marking on there. And like I said, it's for paradox of arrow out of the bow compound. You want it vertical, recurve, you want it horizontal, and that's just because the way you release, how that string drives your arrow forward. And as long as they're all fletched consistent with each other, meaning if I put all cock veins 90 degrees from spine marking, they're gonna perform the same to each other. Now if I fletch half my arrows with the cock vein on the spine marking and half of them with the cock vein 90 degrees, we're probably gonna get two distinctly different groups of arrows. So each group is gonna sit a little bit off from each other just because of the fact that they're not all fletched the same. The paradox of arrow out of the bow isn't gonna be identical to each other. So they're gonna, each group will be consistent with each other, but two different groups won't be consistent as one. So hopefully that helps you guys, speeds up your fletching process. And if you have any questions, comments, concerns, please let us know. Check us out at www.victoryarchery.com, Facebook, Instagram. If you've got any questions, I'd love to hear them. Thanks and have a great day.